Good afternoon, everybody. Thanks for joining us here on the web. Overdoses continue to plague Manchester, with 9 more overnight, adding to the 24 in the previous day. Police say the product, known as spice, is to blame. Marketed as potpourri, people have been using spice instead of marijuana, with dangerous results. Ray Brewer spoke with those who have used this stuff, who say it's cheap and available.
Resembling marijuana and with flavors like bubblegum, blueberry, and lemon lime, spice is responsible for more than 30 overdoses in Manchester in the past 48 hours.
You drive by any of the parks right now in the last couple of days, and you see people that are absolutely lethargic, passed out, very hard to get a response.
In fact, even as police were holding a press conference Tuesday warning of the dangers, several people were being treated for overdosing on spice. Spice is seen as a cheaper alternative to marijuana, but police say this is far more dangerous.
It's a green leafy substance that's sprayed with unknown chemicals and products.
And the application of those chemicals is anything but consistent.
Sometimes if they're more heavy-handed in one area than another, they package this up, and that heavy-handed spray area becomes toxic to those that are inhaling it.
Police say spice is manufactured outside the U.S., eventually finding its way to store shelves in Manchester.
Some of the clerks and owners are saying that, you know, a traveling salesman shows up with this product, which is not good business practice. We'll be checking into that.
Patrol officers fanned out across the city last night, hitting 50 stores, but didn't find any spice. And perhaps the worst is over.
We believe that the product is sold out, and we're hopeful that that's the case, because we do not want to continue dealing with the overdoses that we have for the last 48 hours.
Police say the businesses are cooperating in pulling spice from the shelves, but this problem may not be Manchester's alone. Concord police say they've had 2 overdoses from spice, a juvenile and a 47-year-old as well. Abby Hernandez and her mother, Xenia, reveal new details about what they say happened during the 9 months Abby was missing. The 15-year-old returned home to North Conway last month after police say she was kidnapped by Nathaniel Kibbe. In the statement released by their lawyer last night, Abby and her mom say, quote, "Abby was violently abducted by a stranger for many months. She suffered numerous acts of unspeakable violence. Through her faith, fortitude, and resilience, she is alive today and home with her family." Convicted murderer Seth Mazzaglia will attend his sentencing tomorrow. He has dropped his request to skip that hearing. In a jailhouse phone call to his mother, Mazzaglia said he did not want to go because he would have to listen to Lizzie Marriott's family, quote, yell and whine. But as Heather Hamill reports, his own mother told him the sentencing was for them and he should sympathize with their loss.
In a phone call to his mother last week, Seth Mazzaglia said he felt uncomfortable going to his August 14th sentencing. He said to Heather Mazzaglia, "I already know what everyone's gonna say there, so why the heck do I have to be there? And it's a waste of my time." His mother tried to be understanding of her son, but told him, "It's for them." Mazzaglia was found guilty of strangling 19-year-old Lizzie Marriott and dumping her body into the Piscataqua River nearly 2 years ago. By his phone conversation, it was clear that he didn't feel his conviction was fair. Mazzaglia said, quote, "If I had been found innocent of the big stuff, like I should have been and like I am, now then it might be a different story. Then I might have some sympathy." His mother responding with, "Yeah, all you can do is regret your part in it." To which Seth says, "Yeah, but I'm going to have to sit there for an hour and a half listening to them yell, whine, and moan and scream about how I'm a monster who kills someone when I'm not." The sentencing will be the first time the Marriott family can speak directly to their daughter's killer. And even his mother said, "They're in misery. I mean, they're in agony. Their daughter is lost. I would be the same if it were you. You have to sympathize with what they've lost." Heather Hamill, WMUR, News 9.
And Mazzaglia is facing life in prison without parole. You can watch the entire sentencing live on WMUR-TV and online here at our website, WMUR.com. It all begins tomorrow at 10 a.m. Starting tonight at 5, like it or not, back-to-school shopping is in full swing, and we have some tips to help you save money on those supplies. And another company is offering work to employees who lost hours at Market Basket until the situation there has been resolved. We'll tell you who's hiring. That does it for us. Have a great afternoon, everybody.